end of the day, he was so exhausted. They hiked 10 miles. He was so exhausted. He was just dragging. And they were just kind of carrying him. They looked fine. And he laid down his pad, and he was just, you know, completely without any energy. They were leaving him in the dust. Come to find out that when Dad distributed the weight in the packs, he'd given Ryan a little extra. I said, what, 75 pounds? He said, no, 115.
Oh, my.
He'd been carrying, you know, I've done a little bad bagging, and I know a 40-pound pack is really not ideal, right? 150, yeah. No wonder he was tired. He was carrying weight that did not belong to him, right? He was carrying everybody else's water. Jesus tells us in this little golden nugget from Matthew. This was my favorite verse when I was a child. I had this kind of pinned up on my mirror, and I memorized it, and I went back to it a lot. Because I think it's really easy to pick up burdens that are not ours. And in this story, Jesus is not saying you will not have burdens, or that you don't have work to do, or that everything's going to be swell. I mean, sometimes we hear people say, well, God never gives you more than you can handle, and I never know what that means. Because I sure see people flattened by what they're given. But I hear Jesus saying in this piece, don't take on what isn't yours, because that is what makes it impossible. Take my yours. Learn from me. I am the one who can help you manage this thing. If you take on stuff that isn't yours. You know, there are different kinds of masters, obviously. We have this image with plowing and oxen and yoked oxen of the driver way behind with the whip, right? The kind of leadership Jesus is describing is the one who walks beside the team and makes sure that they take the right path and is there to make sure that they're well matched and properly loaded. What are these burdens that we take on? Everybody's got their own. You probably know what yours are. I have a few of my own. The Apostle Paul, Jesus actually today is talking to people who have been loaded down with shame. They have been told that they're poor or they're sick or whatever because they've done something wrong and they should be ashamed and they have to, you know, there were so many people in that society that were considered unclean and less than and unacceptable. Even folks who were, you know, basically decent people were kind of written off and told that whatever it is that they were bearing is because of something they had done. And God was punishing them. And that is a weight that Jesus absolutely says you don't have to carry. He was known for hanging out, as we heard earlier, with disreputable people. They were his favorite folks. He wasn't worried about that. He came healing. He came accompanying those who had been shamed and ostracized. So whatever your sorrow is, whatever causes you to feel pain, whatever burden you are carrying, you needn't add to it that shame that says you shouldn't feel that way, or you don't need to. You should feel guilty for your burden. I mean, that's just adding an intolerable load, right? The Jesus Christ. But he doesn't tell you what Jesus does. And in some ways, I think the whole of Paul's message is always addressing this. It's always going back to what is liberating for the soul. Paul hasn't figured it all out. He hasn't got it all worked out. But what he knows is this, that he is forgiven. That there is nothing he can do that will alienate him from the love of God. There's nothing. Nothing can separate him from the love of God. He knows this. And he knows that God is walking with him in the midst of his struggle to be the person that he feels called to be. That doesn't mean he still have a burden. He has a burden. He still has to carry a burden. But he doesn't have to carry the additional burden of fearing that God will reject him or push him away or give up on him before he's done. It kind of brings it back to that wonderful AA statement, one day at a time. When you are dealing with a chronic character issue or a chronic addiction or a chronic problem in oneself, the additional burden of shame and guilt that can accumulate is paralyzing. But to be able to go back and say, okay, I blew it again, and I am loved right now, one day at a time, just for today. I'm going to know that I'm loved, I'm going to know I'm forgiven, and I'm not going to carry that weight with me. Another source of weight that some of us carry is a feeling of responsibility for the world. When we look around us, I mean, we are called to be people of compassion, and we are called to be aware of what's going on in our world. And at the same time, it can be absolutely debilitating. Keep us awake at night. We find ourselves taking on things that we cannot change. Cannot necessarily even impact directly. And once again, that image of Jesus as the one who will help us take things proportionally, who invites us to take things proportionally. He says, learn from me. Okay, learn from me. I'll teach you how to do this. Stay close to me, and I will show you how to carry what is yours to carry, because you truly do have a Lord. We all have one. But not to try to carry everything, which will make the whole situation impossible and imbalanced and wear you out. Come to me, Jesus says. All you that are weary and heavy laden is how I remember it. And I will give you rest for your souls. Can't necessarily take away the problems of the world. Can't take away the pain and the difficulty that you may be dealing with. May not even be able to take away your spiritual flaws. But I'll give you some rest. I can give you a break. The masters of perfectionism, the masters of guilt, the masters of alienation are not your friends, and you don't need to hang with them. Jesus is the good shepherd. He is the one that understands and loves us. Is filled with compassion for us and will show us the way. So I'm going to invite you in.